Right, guys, back with the dragon. I am, of course, going to die. Unless I maybe I can get through there. I think he takes it kindly to me coming down here.
Keep it up!
I can maybe get through these. If any of these drop any health, I might be okay for a little bit. Nope. We go again. I didn't buy a resurrection stone, did I? Never mind.
Ready.
Ah.
Become a dragon, Mimir.
Oh, he's no friend of mine. This little scroat was a constant source of annoyance amongst Aesir and Vanir alike.
Then why freedom?
Trust the recently liberated brother. No one deserves to be held captive like this. Dwarf come dragon.
Ready, Ender! Sorry, not ready!
If I throw it over, wait. That's what I was gonna say. If I throw it over, then I'll just catch it on the way back.
Never seen one of those before. They look like they walked straight out of.
Oh, what's this? Does this just take us back to the top where we just been? I don't know. Ah.
Boy.
Nice, so this takes us for a chest. Beautiful.
Ah, I was wondering about this.
Looks like we've got some more lore as well. Fafnir's Tale. If you want to read it, obviously just pause the video. While I'm here, I am just going to have a look and see. We can do some more of this because I'm feeling a little bit like I might be a little bit too weak. Probably not too weak. I'm probably just imagining it, but five targets at once, that'll do. Beautiful. I've got quite a bit of hack silver as well, so hopefully we get some more decent materials. From where this dragon is.
Question head. How did this dwarf become a dragon?
I don't know for certain, though I'd wager his penchant for stealing magical artifacts had something to do with it. Must have stolen a trinket from the wrong Vanir goddess.
ways. There's one more that we're missing. Up there. It's up here, it's gotta be in this side bit. This is the other side of that door, isn't it? I don't know, it's the same door. I think we. Ah! It is in there. I need to climb up. I thought it was the bit where we climbed up. Ah, okay. It didn't look like I could get all the way up here when I came down here before. Oh god.
Not yet.
Four travellers. I'm assuming these guys with the massive swords was a traveller. He was pretty beasty.
I have legs.
Was we not supposed to go up here? I didn't see another room thing. Is it a room? Go back down, try and not get toasted by him. Whoa! Ready? Not ready. Jesus, have we been in here? We have, haven't we? We've been in this bit.
Sir.
See ya. Oh, we must have smashed all three things then.
Go, you wee little bugger. Well, running dragon hasn't done much for his personality.
Rare enchantment. Oh, we'll put that on. That was pretty decent. I'm kind of glad he just went and...
Are you exercising?
Yes, boy, I'm exercising. I'm glad he went and didn't decide to... eat my face. That would have been a little bit disastrous for me. Jesus, we got a lot of that silver from that dude. Right. Well, that's a dragon. Done. And we didn't have to kill him. So that's a win. He left us. Let us live. Pretty tough bloody enemies in this little bit though. That traveller guy. Wasn't expecting him to be there. World Serpent just like, hey. Right, so we need to come back down here. Push the boat back off. Love the way you see the fish jump on the back. That's cool. Through the oarsman, as I said.
Mimir, you never did tell me why Freya spit in your face.
Well, she blames me in large measure for her present circumstances, and not totally without reason. It all goes back to the long war between the Aesir and Vanir. Prior to that, wars for the Aesir were easily won. But the Vanir have proved their equal and exacted devastating damage. Both sides suffered tremendous losses, and for many of us, quite frankly, war was simply no fun anymore, but a rather senseless waste of precious life.
Enough. No stories. Not while on foot. Our focus is the road.
Completely understand. I'll finish later, lad.
Taken from this realm too early.
I'm gonna talk to that dude in a minute.
Ah, good. The special chisel is ahead past this gate.
I don't understand how the elves thought they was stuck in their own lap.
Midgard suffers, deprived of your power, my dear Gulvig.
You who walks among the living, my beloved Gulvig calls to me. She yearns for peace, yet her remains lie in pieces. I beg of you, make my Gulvig whole again.
You want us to collect her bones? Gross.
Gulvig's Sather magic knows no bounds. She can reunite you with those you've lost.
Really? How?
Boy.
I can smell your grief, child. Rest assured, her magic is strong enough to create bridges between life and death. If only for a short while.
Boy, we are leaving.
They've taken three of Sweet Gulvig's bones and spread them across the lake.
Do we
Bring me her bones, child. Gulvig will reward you.
Father, maybe we should look for those bones.
Why?
Didn't you hear him? We could talk to Mom again. If we keep an eye out
look
while
if you wish, boy. I will not be distracted by this fool's errand.
Bless him.
This chisel we seek, what is it?
I'm glad you asked, actually. I have just the story for you. There was a giant once named Thamur. A very giant giant. Who, despite his mountainous size, was without question the greatest stonemason this world had ever seen. Proud Thamur hoped to one day pass his vast knowledge onto his son. But young Hrimthur had the heart of a warrior. Perhaps the father had too much fear in him, or the son too little. Either way, a quarrel of theirs spiraled out of control, and the overworked stonemason, boom, struck his son. Hrimthur ran off into the night. Feeling shame and regret, Thamur chased after his son, but in his emotional state, soon found himself wandering Midgard, lost and alone. Sadly, he caught the eye of the one person he didn't want to meet alone that night, so far from home. Thor.
And? What happened next?
You'll see.
We'll see. You can't just leave it there.
Thor killed him. Oh no. He fell in the village?
Aye. When Thamur fell, he crushed a charming place famed for worshipping the Vanir god Njord. Thor always took credit for planning that one. But truth is, the sweaty claw bag just got lucky.
Giant force hammer up there. Oh!
Hostiles up ahead.
That's just the giant's hand, right?
A dangerous beast. We will take him down together.
Dangerous.
We seek a chisel.
The tip of one, yes. A very, very giant chisel.
Quolver. Just like werewolf to me and you, but nonetheless.
Magically sealed, I'm afraid.
I thought we'd found
all. That big crystal on the giant's ring looked promising.
I shall have to bring in a minute, boy. Once I'm done looting.
Darn, that didn't seem to do anything.
Well, it fell.
Brother, looks like that crystal's brimming again.
Hang on. Ah.
Oh, neat trick, lad.
Thanks. His idea.
My idea, boy. Spin it the other way. Get this other ice. Well, Look, it's only the inside of the ring that's moving. Like it was meant to be like that. Dead giant's hand. Hang on, is that the same mirror or is that the last mirror?
What happened to the survivors?
Oh, Thamur was a frost giant. When he died, his final breath froze everything.
It's locked magically.
Where is it we go then? Oh, there's a book. This. Aha. I found the path, boy. I thought I was going to fall off then. Get around here before. Ah, yes. All these little nooks and crannies with the extra chests in. My kind of party. Runic wormskin pauldrons. Well, they do a lot for runes and defense, but I kind of like mine. Until I can get those other ones. Might be able to get them next time we see the dwarves, I'm not sure.
There he is.
Find the tip of that chisel. That's the magic we need.
Holy shit. He's gigantic. Obviously. He's a giant, but he's literally enormous. Right.
Are we attacking?
Leave this one where it is and catch you in the next one.